Yo, what's up guys, it's Superrockskin here, back at it again, and well, great, he's back on his desktop again. I can only mean one thing, and yeah, today I'm gonna show you guys the best way to remove textures and, on the same time, boost FPS. By the way, this is made by my friend Teaser, so go support him, his channel is in the description. Anyways, let's get right into it, and the first thing is, you will open up your browser and click the first link in the description, it's this one. This will lead you to the client app settings file, aka this is what you need. And don't worry if you don't know, I will show you how to install it. Then you save it on any place, you give it, and pretty much you just download it here, if that will work. Basically, you give it the name, and make sure it's literally just called client app settings.json. Then you save it to your desktop, or anywhere you want to save it, here, then you have this file here. And make sure, and like I said, make sure it's called client app settings.json. Then the next thing you will do is you will open up your Windows menu with your Windows key. Then you type in your Roblox, and then you should see Roblox player. Right click, open file location, right click, open file location again. Then you're in this folder, This is your Roblox installation folder. And basically, if you don't see, like, let's say you don't have this folder, you make right click, new client folder, make a new folder, then call it client set. You call it client settings here, client settings, and then you will move this file into here, and that's pretty much all you have to do. And now I'm gonna go in game and show you guys a bit like what the file all does. All right, now that we're in game, I'm gonna show you off all the things this client settings file does. First of all, the most important thing is it enables the full screen fix and disables the Roblox FPS cap. And with the full screen fix, I mean pretty much it allows you to go into full true screen, which makes your FPS and your, it makes your render latency a lot better, which causes a lot of games to be really laggy and feel really chittery. And the second thing, as you can see, is we have no FPS gap, which is one of the things a lot of people just want from this file. Then, as you can see, first of all, I'm gonna show you guys, we have no textures. You can see I don't have my maps textures disabled right now, but if you go in game, you can see they're still disabled. And this isn't just your typical no textures file. This also disabled, by the way, these are decals, not my fault. It also does something like this. It disables a lot of detect textures. And the second thing, it also disables terrain textures. So basically stuff like this doesn't have terrain. Then it also disables DPI scaling for the few people that are absolutely insane enough to play stretched. It doesn't matter that you don't have to change your sense anymore. Then we also have, it removes grass. This map doesn't have any grass, so I'm gonna give you guys a screenshot. This is a place where it usually would have a lot of grass, but it's just gone, which is very nice. The second of all is it uses a better lightning engine than the default Roblox engine. If I'm not sure which one it uses, but I think it uses the shadow map one, which should be fine. So basically this, and the last thing this client settings file does, it removes shadows and player shadows. Pretty much these shadows are here, but your player doesn't have any shadows. From our testing, cost 1 to 2 frame difference. I know it's not much, but I don't think anyone really cares about your player shadows in total anyways. And here are some FPS differences. I took them with a benchmark program, and this is, the left one is the without anything for any optimization, and the right one is with the optimization. And before anyone says about like, why didn't I take one with the FPS cap enabled, like no FPS cap and default settings, I was lazy, pretty much that. But yeah, this file should help anyone that has a bit, that wants a bit more FPS out gradually. And also, this is true no textures, by the way. This doesn't just remove some textures like some other YouTubers client settings file do. This actually removes them, and you can see the frames are pretty goddamn smooth. And the render latency is also low. And for the people that don't know what render latency is, pretty much the lower this thing is, the smoother your picture goes over. So having 120 frames with 0.1 latency is better than having 240 frames with 5 milliseconds render latency. And you can see, even if I turn my graphics up all the way, you can see there's still no textures. It just makes the edges even sharper, so you could still play with this. Just know it does decrease your render latency a bit. But anyways, this has been all from me, your boy Rauks. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, and obviously subscribe. It's the best way to show me the dislike content I make. Normal upload resume tomorrow. Anyways, we see you straight in the next one. Ciao, ciao.